a field now here, where once many a house was, and many a tree with cherries and light, and many a mother with dresses the color of a raspberry in June, all gone. I didn't come to the castle. The castle, it comes to me. And when the king sets fire to all these forests, the king then says to me, "I'm just trying to keep y'all warm." He makes me a song inside somebody else's mouth. What I wrote in somebody else's throat. They burn my body with fire and then they charge me back for the smoke. Split their fists in my face, blood on the knuckles, then tax me for the stain. Pulled the trick the same way when it came to these streets, these homes. Said to my man, soon as we seize a pale girl with a small dog in parts she wasn't here before, we both know this kingdom ain't ours for much more. So now, every restaurant I pass, they sit with a pint glass, and no one, when I pass by, offers up a hello. They do not see me, cannot touch me, cannot even offer me up ground to eat off of, no earth to be buried inside of. Nothing can I own, not my home, not my place of birth, shit, not even my own heart, not my body, not my skin, not anything that the spirit is tethered to. If not even the anchor of my body is mine, then what do I have to hold this soul in this life? What am I, a ghost? Unseen, unfelt. The body untouched. It's got a spirit that can't hold, so it's like a soul that got stuck and took while the body just stays, and they take everything that we already done gave. They bury us, and then they kick us out of our own grave, and on top of the hole, they build another house and say, "You still got your voice while we take your mouth." Better to claim that they can't hear us whenever we try to cry anything out. Do you know what it means to be a thing that is always leaving with no place to go? We go nowhere. And no place to return. We become a something sung only from under somebody else's tongue. What we write now can only live inside somebody else's mouth. They set our children on fire and then complain about the light. Pull the trick the same, pull out our eyes and say, "Shh, that dark you see, well, that's just the night."
Really good job at preserving white neighborhoods, and I do mean neighborhoods, but Portland also did a very good job at destroying black neighborhoods and community. And so when we talk about this, I want to talk about everybody's disillusion with generational wealth. Just because you own a home doesn't mean you have generational wealth, and that's the game that's being played. But I want to talk about generational knowledge and the transfer of that knowledge that's lost when you uproot community. I want to talk about political clout and political might and political power that is destroyed when you uproot and dismantle and destroy community.
I'll tell you, just to get to the nuts and bolts of it, let's talk about how our neighborhoods and communities were studied from afar before an attack was even made.
The Negro problem.
Let's talk about how, as we would constantly move down from Vanport into the inner city of Albina, let's talk about how we developed those neighborhoods into a vibrant economy and how that was targeted.
By 1956, right here in this area, there were over 100 businesses.
Come on.
There were over 100 businesses. We're talking about people who were on the move. We're talking about people who acquired skills at Vanport, and because they had housing, they were able to save their money. And so when they came to Albina, they had skills. A lot of them already had college, you know, college educated, college degrees. And so one thing I get tired of is this narrative is that Central Albina was just a bunch of poor black folks.
Right. And then you have the apartments that you can never own. And then around it, you have a sea. It's like an apartment in a sea of million-dollar homes that are now $1 million that weren't when, black folks lived here, because redlining made it to where our houses didn't accrue in any value. In fact, they lost value.
Call it whatever we're going to call it, redlining, red tagging. Those are just the instruments used that a people are used by a people to stop the progress of another people.
Ships have no one on board. If a ship empty, what the captain for? Lord, Lord, Lord. What am I for, my people are gone? What my body for? If not for holding on to others, my body already a boat of its own, its ocean, the soul, and the soul, the boat's hold.
Oh!
boat be the body, the home. The 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 boat be the body, the home.